So hello friends and welcome here. We are going to do a quick unboxing here of the Shure Beta 27, a microphone that I just got myself to test it out. It is a large diaphragm condenser microphone. On the back we see precision sound, primary performance, and we are going to check out if that is the case. So on the side we have some more information about the microphone, the different product lines of the Shure microphones, which are the PG, the SM, the Shure Beta, and then the most premium is the KSM microphones. And some information about the microphone. It is a large diaphragm side addressed microphone. On the side we also have some company information, what's included in the box, which is the Shure Lock hard mount. On the other side we have multiple languages, just some regular description. And now let's open up the box and see what is inside. So the microphone comes in this cardboard package. When you open it up, you get presented with some instructions. You get a little Velcro strap to strap your cable out of the way. You get a Shure sticker, some warranty information, and of course the Shure Beta 27 user guide. And then the microphone comes in a padded box. So you get this leather pouch. It has the Shure emblem embossed in. It's a nice case, I have to say. And when we open it up, it's also a padded case. So it's not just a leather case to get the microphone in. So also in the case, we have a mount adapter. We have the hard lock mount that screws directly into the microphone. And we also have the microphone itself. So let's get this out of the way and have a closer look at the Shure Beta 27. So first, on the front we have the Shure emblem and also the indication of the polar pattern, which is hyper-cardioid. Then we have a paired switch and the other one is a low cut filter. And it's a two position low cut filter. So we have two positions, a low cut and a low cut at a higher frequency. I will give you the information and just blend it in. And we also have this very interesting microphone mount. So compared to most other microphones, this one seems to be patented and it does not have any loose elements. It screws directly onto the microphone. So there is no screw that goes into the mount and then into the microphone. It's all one piece and then you can mount it wherever you wish. So this is just to give you a rough introduction to the microphone. So now I want to give some examples, some other microphones, just so we can compare the size. So I got my Shure SM58 here, and I have to say the Shure Beta 27 is a relatively small condenser microphone. I expected it to be larger, but I was surprised when I took it out of the box. So it's even smaller than the SM58, but it is a little bit heavier. And now let's compare the Shure Beta 27 to the Rode Procaster dynamic microphone, which is insanely huge compared to the Shure microphone. So they have a similar mount, but the mount of the Rode is out of plastic and the screw attachment is separate. So it's two pieces and for the Shure it's just one. And you can see the Shure is just maybe two-thirds of the size of the Rode Procaster, and it's also lighter than the Procaster. But that does not influence the build quality. The Shure is an exceptionally built microphone. And I also want to share you the basket here. So if we look through, we can make out the diaphragm, the capsule itself, but you see the mesh are basically two layers, one thicker and sturdier layer and one smaller that should deflect some of the pop sounds, but basically it lets all the air through. Okay, that's the unboxing part. Let's quickly go over the specs of the microphone. First off, it is a condenser microphone, needs some external power. Frequency response is 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz or 20 kHz. The polar pattern is super or hyper-cardioid, so it is a little bit more narrow than a regular cardioid microphone. The impedance is usually 160 ohms. Pressure level is 134 decibels with the pads which engage it is 148 decibels. The signal to noise ratio is 85.5 decibels. The dynamic range is 125 decibels and an incredible self noise of 8.5 decibels. In terms of the polarity, it only has the one polar pattern, which is the cardioid. The weight is 428 grams or 15.1 ounces. It comes with a switch for attenuation, which is minus 15 dB, and has a low cut filter, also engageable via a switch. The switch has two modes. One is minus 6 decibels for a cutoff frequency of 115 Hz or minus 18 decibels for a cutoff at 80 Hz. Connector obviously is the standard XLR 3-pin connector and it is powered by 48 volt phantom power. I really hope you liked this video. We are going to do another video of this microphone where we compare it to the AKG C214 and I'm excited about comparing these two. So follow up with the upcoming videos, subscribe to the channel and I see you in the next video.